Welcome back. You're still with this edition of Point of View. We've been in conversation with Robert Miner, president at Dynamic Trading Group, getting his views on the technicals of world markets as they're shaping up. Robert, before we went into the break, we were talking a little bit about the U.S. markets. The U.S. dollar seems to be the pivotal force around which everything is moving these days. What's the call on the U.S. dollar when you look at it at this point?
I'm fairly strongly convinced that the U.S. dollar has begun a bull trend, and it's going to take out the March highs, and it'll continue up at least into late 2010 and possibly well into 2011. So maybe doing just the opposite of what most people are anticipating.
Specifically against the euro and the yen, how much would you give it?
Whew, can you bring a chart up? I'm a technical analyst chartist. I can point to the levels. But this would, of course, mean that the euro is going to be in a bear trend.
Sure.
If the dollar is going to be in a bull trend. Unfortunately, I can't give you the specific numbers, being the chartist. And I should have looked at the specific numbers before coming on. Yeah.
Sure. Gold's been a good hedge for some time now. And it's turned very volatile of late. How are you calling this commodity?
I suspect gold is going to be sideways to down for many months. Of course, if the dollar is projected to be stronger, more than likely gold is going to be weaker. So we have probably topped out. Technically wise, is we've breached a little what we call a double bottom here, I think just yesterday or within the last couple, 3 days. And that's a very negative signal that it wasn't able to hold that area. And we've fallen back into the range. I believe we've reached the range of where the highs were about a year or so ago. So we've come up that breakout, turned around very sharply, came down. That's a really bearish technical sort of pattern.
Good to go short on gold then?
Well, I'd wait a few days until we get some kind of a bounce. I actually have some timing on the weekly and daily that we're due a short-term bottom in gold by the end of next week at the latest. Then I'd be looking at, I use a lot of my own unique momentum indicators. I would be looking for a weekly momentum then to get overbought and to turn around before I'd look to get short.
What's the worst case scenario for gold in this year, you think? How low could it possibly go?
I could easily see it down another $200 easily before the end of the year.
From the high or from current levels?
From current levels.
So it would make sense to go for a short with a respectable stop loss, at least on gold then?
Yes. Yes. Once we have that bounce back up. We've come down so hard and it's near a timing a low that we want to wait for it then to have its bounce up and look for that timing high. And then it'll probably be a great short setup.
A lot of technical analysts I've spoken to, Robert, off late, ever since this corrective process began a few weeks back, have been looking at copper as a bit of a lead indicator, even to predict equities. Is there a very high correlation between the way copper prices move and the way equities move? And if you have a reading on copper, what would it be?
And unfortunately, I don't. And I don't know the correlation. I've certainly read about those correlations, but I don't look at too much intra-market analysis. I look at each one individually. Because those intra-market market relationships don't necessarily hold true over long periods of time. And so you can get kind of caught up in, well, in the last few months, you know, gold's up a dollar and the dollar's down a few ticks or whatever. It's not necessary that over the last 10 or 20 years those relationships have held. So if I look at the individual market, I make a decision just on that market.
What's the closest correlator to equities right now? People talk about the Dolex, for example. Is that something that you would watch very closely to predict the movement of equities or commodities?
No, I'd only look at to predict and anticipate. I don't like the word predict. Again, I look for conditions with high probability outcomes. But for looking into the future, I only look at that individual market and do all my technicals, my time and price and pattern sort of relationships. I've developed some kind of unique timing relationships I call dynamic time projections and dynamic price projections that have a good probability of picking probable highs and lows of whether you're looking at intraday data or monthly data, either one. So,
what's the call on the dollar index or the Dolex specifically?
Dollar index is eventually before the year is out, I suspect it'll take out the March high. So that's a significant trend up.
This is also termed to be the year of inflation. Progressively, I think consensus is that stimulus packages will be withdrawn. You'll probably look at tightening both to control the liquidity on the banking side as well as beyond. And crude is at the centrifugal force of it all, given the large importers of crude as we are. How closely are you watching crude right now? And despite the recent correction that we've seen. Are you more optimistic or pessimistic on this commodity?
I'd be a little bit more pessimistic. Because the consensus is inflation, I tend to look at the other side. And I want it to, because it seems to be the overwhelming view is that because of the stimulus packages and money supply, et cetera, that we're going to have this big inflationary period. But when I look at the dollar probably bottoming, and in a cyclic trend that lasts another year to 18 months, maybe even longer. And when I look at gold, the probabilities that it's going to be declining over the next several months to a year or two, that doesn't say inflation to me, that says deflation, if anything. So, and also just because it's the overwhelming consensus seems to be that we're gonna have some big massive inflation over the next year or two, I tend to think we're gonna have just the opposite of what people are expecting.
Could it go down to $50 to the barrel, you think?
Yeah, that's a possibility. You know, that's what is it at now? 76 or 77?
About 73, 74.
Yeah. I would call that even a probability that eventually it could reach back down to that 40.
How much probability would you assign to it?
I'd give it 70-80% right now. Yeah, that eventually it could get down to that in the next year or two.
Jim Rogers happens to believe that the demand for oil is so high and that there's not enough supply out there. And so the only way oil prices can move is up just because of this demand-supply gap. Would it surprise you at any point, maybe in 10 or perhaps even in 2011, if crude decided to take a dash at 150, the all-time high? Would it surprise you?
Well, Jim Rogers is a pretty smart guy, so I hate to contradict him. So I guess I wouldn't be surprised, you know, sort of, but I just tend to think that in the long term, he's probably correct. Whether that's a correct analysis over the next 3 to 6 months, I'm not so sure. You know, I would say if we're going to take another run at 150, it's going to be a little bit further down the road after we have a more of a corrective decline.
All right, Robert, hold that thought. We need to take another break on this. So when we come back, we'll touch on the two markets that concern us the most, our Indian markets, of course, and what's happening in China and what it could mean for the Indian markets. We'll be back in just a couple of minutes. Stay tuned.